Happened to the Flint water crisis.
In tonight's Whatever Happened To, a look at one city's crisis that caught the attention of the nation. Jody on Twitter wanted to know, whatever happened to the water in Flint, Michigan? And on Facebook, Stephanie Forbes Hayward said that she would like to hear some follow-up on the Flint water crisis because she heard the issue has not been resolved. Well, Jody and Stephanie, tonight, senior correspondent Mike Tobin has an update.
Ever since Justice McDonald has been big enough to brush his own teeth, he's done it with bottles.
His name is Justice McDonald. I thought that was like a Supreme Court person for a second, and then it's like,
that his actual name is Justice?
Justice, yes. McDonald.
Water.
We have no other option. I'm definitely not going to take the chance on my children's health.
In April of 2014, under emergency management, Flint, Michigan switched from the Detroit water system to the Flint River as a temporary solution to save money. Residents complained about smell, even hair loss from the water. Lead contamination was detected when doctors found lead in children.
Here's the culprit, one of the lead pipes in the city of Flint water system. You see, the water out of the Flint River didn't necessarily have...
That's actually why they banned it, because if you see unleaded gasoline, because at first these kids would be playing and there'd be all these cars and industrial stuff going on, and we'd get into the soil and kids would play, and then they would get higher levels of lead exposure, just like lead paints, another thing. So getting lead into your system is not good, and to save money, it didn't save money. Now they have to replace all these pipes because of all the corrosion and the lead it leached off these fucking pipes with this water they had from the river there that was just disgusting. So... it's kind of funny.
Even pencils used to be made out of lead, right? Like now they had to move to graphite because kids would chew on their pencils.
Yeah.
Or they get poked by it and it would break the skin.
Yeah.
You know,
lead was a corrosive chemical. And when that water,
because you use lead,
ran through these household pipes, it ate away at the lining right there, therefore exposing the household water to lead. Once the leaching of the lead starts, you can't stop it. Crews are at work, but 3 years into the problem, less than 25% of the lead pipes have been replaced. Poisonous water flows into most houses.
I'm confused as to why help just
doesn't
pour in.
The problem you have, too, is even after they do it, is you have a huge perception problem. You have a community that's going to be totally distrusting of the government at this point because it failed them so drastically, and it's like you see why. It's like, oh well, this is fine, this is a temporary fix, and the fix ended up hurting a lot of people and injuring them and forced them to use bottled water. So now they're basically like, even if they replace it, who's going to really trust the source of the water?
This is like way too long to let this problem still exist. Like they throw money at hurricanes and shit like that because it's a natural disaster. This is a man-made fuck up. Like, they need to pay to make this happen. FEMA should come in if the city's not going to do it. Well, this is just ridiculous.
Well, even the area, you know, the country Ben's from, remember the algae bloom they had in the Lake Erie?
Yeah. In Toledo, they couldn't drink their water for a long time. And you could even see it from satellite photos, this big green blob.
It's just crazy. Like, people don't think about this stuff, but when you pollute, you're affecting all these rivers and streams and these bodies of water that people rely on to drink and do all the stuff with. And without water, I mean, even more so than food, you can go without food for like a month and potentially still survive. Without water, you're dead in 3 days. And if you don't have clean water, you're fucked. That's it.
To the city just to replace everybody's pipes.
Brigadier General Michael McDaniel was appointed to oversee the replacement in February of 2016.
Well, there was no project at that point. Nothing had been done.
People in Flint believe recovery is slow because they are poor.
I think a lot of the issues that we deal with at the state and federal levels would be different if you were interacting with people who had influence.
12 people died of Legionnaires' disease after bacteria festered in stagnant pipes. Now 15 state and city officials are facing criminal charges ranging up to involuntary manslaughter.
You taking Thomas?
The McDonald's 4-year-old son Josiah is autistic. There is no conclusive link, but some studies suggest lead poisoning contributes to autism.
Look at him scooting around on this little scooter thing. That boy autistic.
Those scooters aren't easy to drive. I don't blame it on the autism. I tried to ride one of those and it fucking broke and the crack went up my ass and pinched my butt. I don't blame the autism on that one. That's just bad design. Like, give him like a little tricycle. You can ride a tricycle.
Oh, shit, Scotty.
I don't really hold any grudges against anybody.
Oh, shit! Ooh.
Happy Halloween, everybody! Ooh. So we're dressed up for Halloween.
Oh my god, this is like a fucking landmine. This is like you step on a landmine and you don't know what to do. Because like, what the fuck are you going to say that is not going to make you seem like the biggest fucking racist in the world?